friends, in previous classes we have discussed about the history of electrical cables. Let us recall about the our electrical cables used in our electrical fields. As we know that the power generation takes place in generating station, that power has to be transmitted to load center with help of two modes. One mode is the overhead lines with help of physical structures, poles, steel towers, etc. Where it is not possible to establishment of overhead lines, then we preferred the underground cables. Though the underground cables are initial cost is more, but it has the some advantages over overhead lines. As we discussed clearly in yesterday, the underground cables are rugged in constructions, is a greater service reliability, safety, less chances of faults, low maintenance of cost, better appearance, lesser interference from external disturbances, for example lightning, ice falling, trees, branches falling and storms. At the same time, it has some disadvantages also as comparing to the overhead lines. As we discussed, due to these all benefits, we have to incur some cost. So initial cost is more manufacture of cables. At the same time, the erection of cable underground, the insulation problems also increases if voltage range increases from LT to HT, HT to EHT and EST. At the same time, the gap between the cables, R phase, Y phase, B phase, then each conductor acts as a capacitor plates. In between, the insulation acts as a dielectric media. Then the large charging currents maybe takes place in the cable. Okay, so hence the cables are preferred where it is not practicable to use overhead lines, then we can use these cables. At the same time, the thickly populated areas just prefer these cables. What do you mean the cable? Cable is a device which consists of conductor and insulation combinations which can transform energy from one end to the another end. The cable is another way. It has one or more conductors covered with a suitable insulation and surrounded by a protective layers. You can see in the figure here the copper conductors, 4 core cable, and this each core is covered with a XLPE insulation, cross linked polyethylene insulation, and these 4 cores bound by is a binding tape. Before that, the gap in between the 4 cores, the pillars, insulating pillars are filled, and over which a sheath is provided with a PVC inner sheath. It acts as a bedding and over which there is a steel wire armors. Sometimes we can use a steel or aluminium, and shape may be round or flat, and over which we are using the SN materials, the jute materials, that is the binding tape over the armoring. And finally, we are going to use the sheath which can withstand atmospheric conditions and all protections from the entering of the gas, chemicals, anything into the cable. So we are using the PVC outer sheath. This is a basic idea of cables. Now at the same time, we classified cables also based on the different factors. So number of conductors in a cable and voltage range of the cable and using up the sheathing for different applications and what are the different type of the dielectric media used in the cable. Classification takes place, already we discussed. At a glance, the based on the number of cores, here the core 1, core 2, core 3, core 4, this is a 4 core cable. Sometimes single core also, and double core, triple core, and 4 core. So based on this classification, based on the conductors, single core cable, double core cable, and 3 core cable and 4 core cable, classification based on the cores. Now classification based on the voltage, this voltage can be used based on the whether it's a LT cable, that voltage up to the 1 kV, that is a 1000 volts, and HT cables, then so more than 1000 volts to 11 kV, and ST super tension cable above the 11 kV and up to 33 kV voltage. And sometimes we can use further the EHT cable. So before that one, EHT, extra high tension cables. So in this cable, the cable capacity up to 66 kV voltage. More than 66 cable, so we can use a EST cable, extra super tension cable. So these cables are used above 66 kV and up to the 132 kV voltage. So these are the voltages based on cable. The cables are classified based on the voltage. So these are the voltage ranges approximately. And another factor is the based on the applications, whether it's a belted cable and H type cables and SL type cables and HSL type cables. These are the special type of the cables used in our power system to carry the heavy current and high voltages. Okay, already last class we discussed. Now in this class we are going to draw its plan and evaluation. And another factor for classification of cables is the dielectric media used in the cable. So whether you are going to use a solid dielectric media like the papers and PVC insulation, polyethylene, different types of solids. Sometimes we can use the liquids also. So based on the oil filled cables, sometimes we can use the oil from the external pressure. So external oil pressure cables also we can use it. This oil can be used as a cooling media as well as the dielectric strength between the conductors. And we can use another type is a gas as a dielectric media. So gas pressure type cables also we can use for the high voltage purposes. Okay, these are the four factors we have to consider while classification of the cables. Okay, now the cable, each cable consists of the mainly, every cable consists of mainly the these layers. So each cable consists of mainly, first is required the conductors. So whether the based on the core, here the simple core, 3-core cables, and the core, this is the conductors, whether aluminium or copper conductors, or which we require some insulating material. So here I can use the paper as an insulating material. So paper insulation over the each conductors, and these conductors are tied together with filling the paper insulations, and over which we can use the sheet material to bind this one, 3, and sheath we can use another material where the sheath may be lead sheet, and over which we can use and bedding. We can use cable, this is a bedding. So bedding here, so let us okay, so this is a conductor. The conductors are main current carrying elements. These are made up of the aluminium or copper. The copper conductors are heavier and current capacity is 1.6 times greater than the aluminium conductors, you know. Whereas these are the first layer of the insulation, the paper insulation. These insulations, the each conductor separated from the other conductors, and so different type of the insulations may be used in our electrical field. As you know that varnishes, enamel coatings, impregnated papers, and sometimes we can use a cambric or rubber mineral compounds generally used in our electrical fields. And over this we are going to use the metal sheath, the metallic sheath. Here the metal sheath is covered 3 core materials. This metal sheath may be, sometimes we can use aluminum sheath or copper sheath or lead sheath, and it is the earthed potential. So mainly the metallic sheath is used to protect from the entering of the moistures, acids, alkalis and gases in the soil and atmospheric area, and over which there is a bedding is used here. The bedding generally used the some jute materials and SCN tape generally used. A layer of bedding is placed over the metallic sheath of a cable to protect from the corrosions. Okay, at the same time it will support to the armoring also. Now over this bedding, so we are going to use so another type of the material, that is the mainly armorings. So these are the galvanized steel strips, or we can say these are the all strips. Mainly this armoring is for mechanical protections. Over the bedding, the armoring is provided, which consists of one or two layers based on our requirement. So layers of galvanized steel wires or steel tapes, and this is also provided at zero potential with earthing. Okay, so this is mainly the mechanical protection purpose. At the same time, it is stable to the cable also. And over which, so there is another final servicing. So this is the main use of the servicing. So the servicing is nothing but it is an insulating material, and it can withstand from all atmospheric conditions, sun rays, all things. Okay, so this is a just like service wire, you can observe. So that is taken to your home from the nearby PSC poles. Okay, this is a serving. This is the armoring. Okay, these are the basic cables. Cable consist, as we discussed yesterday. Okay, so any cable consists of this. If voltage increases, then the layers of this insulating materials increases. If voltage increases. Okay, so this layer, next layer, next layer, next layer, next layer, different insulation materials we are going to use with the voltage increases from the L2 voltage to H2 voltage. If the current value increases from 1 ampere to 100 amperes, so then we are going to increase the cross sectional area of the conductors. If 1 ampere, so SWG of the core is more, and if the current increases, the cross-sectional area of the cable increases. That means the size of the conductors depend on the current, and size of the insulating material depend on the voltage. Okay, so these are the discussed in previous class. At the same time, we have drawn the single cross-sectional view of the single layer cable. Okay, so at a glance you can see how we have taken. So here first I taken the some conductors, cables. Okay, so here the cable is, these are the conductors, standard conductors for the flexible purpose. Then over which I used another line tape. Okay, so I can use a line tape here. So this is a line tape, so insulating material, and over which I used another type of the insulating material. Now over which I am going to use, this is the rubber insulation. Rubber insulation. And over which I can use another type of the insulating material, that is a tape. Insulating material. And finally, I can use the sheath. So these are the single core cable. So what we have discussed here, this is the conductor, this is the insulating material, that is the line tape, and over which, so we use the rubber insulation, and over which I used the another tape insulation, and finally I used a service that is a sheath, PVC sheath. So these are the single core cable, dear students. So if you are seeing, this is a elevation. Suppose you want to see, so this side, this direction, we are going to draw the plan. I am going to draw the plan. Here it taken the same center as a conductors, and over which there is a insulating material, that is the line tape. Okay, this is the line tape, over which there is a rubber sheath. This is the rubber sheath. Next, over which there is a tape insulation. So by using your circulars you can try it, and over which there is a sheath material. So this is a plan. So if you extend the lines, this is the sheath, and you extend this line, it is going to the tape, so you are going to get the same these values. Okay, with the help of your drafter, just extend it, you are going to get the plan. Your aim is to draw elevation and plan. Okay, so this is the elevation and this is the plan, you are going to try it. Okay, so this is the single sectional view of single core cable. Similarly, last class we have drawn three core cable, three core XLPE cable, okay, cross linked polyethylene cable. So where it has a consist of the same three cables. So each, so I am going to write the plan and elevation. So similarly, if you know the plan, what is the, what consists of the, this three core cable? So three cores. So this is a one core, and this is another core, and this is another core. Okay, so before this core, so there is a different types of layers inside. So if you have seen that, so here, so inside there is a conductors. So eat these conductors and conductors, or which there is a the screen, insulation screen is provided. So insulation screen, for example, take it. So another insulation screen is provided over the conductors, and over which there is a XLPE insulation. So there is another type of the insulation used here. So this is a XLPE insulation. Okay, then once again they will use another the insulating screen on which. So insulating screen. And finally they will use the copper screen. Okay, so here we can use the copper screen. So this is a, let us assume this is a copper screen, this is a copper screen, and this is the copper screen. So three are attached. These are three core cables. Okay, so what is inside? There is a aluminium or copper conductor, or which the insulating screen, or which XLPE insulation over which and the insulation once again, and finally there's a copper screen is provided each core. Similarly, core 1, core 2, core 3 is placed here, and one is a non-woven tape is bound these cables. So this is the three cores are bound with help of non-woven tape, just like you can see the black color tape available in the market. Okay, this is the non-woven tape. After that, they will provide another insulating material that is known as the PVC inner sheath. So over which there is a PVC inner sheath. So it acts as a just like a jute material, the bedding material. Now over which there is a armoring. So armoring material, that is the galvanized steel materials. So armoring, this is a in round shape or flat shape, this is a mechanical purpose. Then this is a armoring. And over which, so we are going to use that is the PVC over sheath. Finally, we are going to use it PVC over sheath. So that is act as a servicing. This one. Okay. So now, dear students, what is this one? This is a PVC over sheath. Next, so what is this one? Armory. GI, galvanized iron armored. GI and galvanized steel. Okay, wire armored. And what is this one? This is the PVC insulation, PVC inner sheath, over sheath, outer sheath, that is the inner sheath. Inner sheath. Next, what is this one? So over which we are used the non-woven tape. Okay, so non-woven tape insulation material. And so what is this this one? Copper screen. Copper screen. Okay, so next, inside the material. So if you go in the, that is the, once again, this is the another is the insulating screen. And here the another is a XLPE insulation. Okay, next, and over the conductors another layer that is known as the insulating screen. And finally we are going to reach a center point, that is the conductor. So these are the layers of a 3-core XLPE insulated armored cable. Since the plan, dear students, just you extend the these lines, you are going to get the elevation. Okay, so let us see this one in your book. You can see here the sectional view of 3-core XLPE cable. Okay, so just what we have discussed, the aluminum or copper conductor inside, over which we are using the conductor, the screen, okay, over which we are using the XLPE insulation, and over which we use the insulation screen, and the over finally we are use the copper tape screen. So this is the one core. Similarly, remaining two cores and three cores are bound with the help of the non-woven tape, and over which we are use the PVC inner sheath, and over which we use the galvanized steel wire armored, and over which we use the PVC oversheath. These are the screen. So you are going to draw, okay? So this similar to this one, conductors over which and over which, and similarly these two and over which you are going to draw it, students. Okay, very easy to draw this. Just by seeing this figure, you draw it. Okay, you have the instruments. Draw it. Okay, now you can draw another figure. So similarly, you are going to draw it here. Now you can draw. This is a cross-sectional view of two-core cable. So previously we had drawn the three-core cable. Here two-core cable. Now we can see the shape of this two-core cable also. So what is the here also? There is the two cores. The conductors you can see here. So this is the conducting one core, and this is the strands, aluminium or copper strands. Okay, and here over which they used the sheath lead. You can see this is this one, and over which we use the proofread tape. Okay, proofread tape, and this is the one core. Here is the another core, and each this core aluminium conductor is bound by using the proofread core. This one, and so these are bound with a VIR insulation, vulcanized Indian rubber sheath insulation, and over which we used the another the belt paper. So this is bounded by the belt paper, you can see here, and over which they used the impregnated paper, and over which they used the here is a lead sheath inside. Okay, so you can see here clearly in this elevation. First this is used the conductors, next over which they use the VIR insulation, vulcanized Indian rubber insulation, and over which they use the bound. This is the one conduct core, this is another core, and both cores are bound with the help of this insulation. There's a tape, so it's normal insulation tape, and over which they use the impregnated paper, sometimes we can use, and over which another insulation. You can see here what is that insulation. So we get the lead sheath, I think. Okay, so this is a lead sheath, and this is the impregnated paper, that is the insulation, and the belt paper. You can see the belt paper, and over which you use the sheath. Okay, simple. This is the same. Our main five items is required for the a good cable. What are that one? First the conductor, paper insulation, lead sheath, a bedding, armoring, servicing. So we required for the cables. Here the different type of the insulations used for the different applications only. Okay, sometimes we can the paper, sometimes the impregnated paper, sometimes the oven tape, sometimes the VIR insulation. So different type of the insulations based on their characteristics and applications. Okay, so we draw it. The twin core belted cable. This is the plan. This is the elevation. Okay, and similarly, we draw it. That is a sectional view of three core belted cable. Say the belted cables are generally used. So three cores. You can see here. This is the one. This is the two. This is the three. Three cores. Okay, each core is. Over this is a used another type of insulation. You can see here. Okay, let us see that one. The conductors 1 and 2, 3 conductors, and over which this is line and tape used here. You can see this one, and over which this three cores are bound with help of the another tape. You can see this tape. Okay, then they are used the VIR insulation, vulcanized Indian rubber insulation, also used over the conductors. Then the belted paper or paper is used to belt the three combine the cores, over which they are used the servicing material. Okay, this is a plan and this is a elevation, dear students. They draw it simply. Okay, three core cables is a sectionals. You can see it. Similarly, you draw it sectional view of three core with steel wire armored. Here we are not used the any metallic strips here. Okay, so here I used the metallic strips. You can see similar arrangements. Here what has happened? Inside there is a conductors, and over which there is a, I used the some insulation. Okay, so VIR insulation I used here, and over which I can use the proof tape. So here I use the proof tape, and I use the over which so VIR insulation and as a bedding, and I use the steel armoring, and over which I use the final sheath, that is a lead sheath. I can use it, and some pillars also I am going to use it. Okay, so by seeing this figure, just you draw it. Okay, so what is consist? It consists of the conductors, and it consists of the lead sheath and the cotton packing and VIR insulation, the preferred tape. Different preferred tape is used over the conductors. You can see black wire, you can see it. Okay, so dear students, this is the similar. Your aim is to draw it. Okay, so these are different insulating materials based on the applications. Okay, so you draw it. Example, the cross sectional view of three end of core. This is a three end of core material. We are going to write it. Okay, so first of all, you take this one. So what is the action? So cross sectional view of three end of core cable, that is the XLPE. Okay, cable we are going to write. Insulated armored cables, they require the armored cables also. So what is the cross sectional view of three end of core XLPE? Okay, cross linked polyethylene insulated armoring cable is required. So we are going to draw this figure. Okay, so don't worry. So by seeing this figure, you draw it. So here what is the three end of three cores and off. Okay, so that purpose, so it just you draw it. So what is required here? It take the one insulation, one four cores, na. So here you draw it. So take the one small circle. Okay, that is known as the PVC bedding, the insulating material. Then make it four parts. Here four parts. Now you can use the insulating material, that is also PVC insulation. Okay, PVC insulation. You can take the another color. The PVC insulation. Here the each PVC insulation material. And here you can take the off cable is the round shape. Now inside conductor is required. Now you fill with the conductors. So this is the conductor strands. Conductor strands. Okay. Now over which there is a binding tape also provided. That's a PVC binding, and the PVC binding act as a binding bedding, and PVC bedding, you can see the PVC over which you can use the armoring. So you can use the armoring insulating materials, that is the galvanized metals armoring. So this is a galvanized steel wires, so mechanical support. Okay, and over it there is a, you can use the PVC jacket, and finally you are going to use it. So for example, a green color cable, so you can use the PVC cable. Okay, so this is a 3 1/2 core cable. So what it consists, let us see. So inside, it consists, what is the conductors? Conductors. Next, and next is a PVC insulation and binding. These four core also, we are used the PVC binding. So PVC, we are used the bedding, and here I can use the galvanized steel armor, and finally I can use the PVC jacket. So PVC, so jacket as a serving. So this is the cable, you are going to dry it. So 1 2, this is 1 2 3, this is off 3 1/2 XLPG cable. Okay, so you can see this one in your textbook. Okay, so what it consists of? It consists of a plain copper conductors. You can see it, this is the copper conductors, and over which use the PVC insulation. You can see this is the PVC insulation separated by the conductor to conductors, and they use the another PVC bedding, so combining purpose here, and over which they use the steel armoring, over which there is the PVC jacket. This is a black one. Okay, very easy to draw this figure. Okay, so dear students, please write it, right, and draw the another sectional view of 4-core belted cable. So belted cable, sectional view of the 4-core belted. Yes, you can. This is the belted cable. Similar. So whatever the cables is given here, you can see it. So inside there is the conductors here, you can see, and over which there is a line and tapered. The line and tapered is the over the conductors, and these four conductors are bound with help of the VIR insulation, and this over which VIR insulation has a belted tape also provided here, and over which they use the sheath. So this is the sheath, this is the, you can use the belted tape, and you can use the VIR insulation. These are the insulations, and line and tape, and this is the conductors. Okay, just you draw it by seeing this figure. So this is a sectional view of 4-core belted cables. Here I am not used any armoring. Okay, so let us draw another figure also, that is a cross sectional view of armored 4-core XLPE insulated cable. You can see, draw it here. Okay, so what it consists, similar to the same. Okay, so I can draw this. Take first the conductor. So take the one conductor here. Okay, so what is this one filled with? So this conductor
copper or aluminum conductors, and or which there is a insulating material. So that insulation is the insulating material. This one, okay, the insulating material. Next, similarly, another core. Okay, so four core cables separated by some insulating material and bound this one through this one. Okay, so that is the binding cable, conductor, the insulating materials, and inside, so there's some pillars also used inside here to mechanical purpose, and at the same length electrical pillars. Okay, this is one cable, second core, three core, four core cables. Okay, now over which so pillars and core, and we can use some the core wrapping. Here use the core wrapping. Four cores are wrapped with help of the insulating material. Next, I used the another bedding for the so armoring I am going to use. So I require the some bedding material is required here. So that is the some jute material. This is the bedding material over which I can use the armoring. So this is the galvanized steel strips, whether it's a round shape or a flat shape. Okay, so the mechanical protection. This is the galvanized steel fetters. Okay, then another, lastly, the servicing. Servicing is nothing but so some we can use the outer sheath. So I can use the outer sheath for the cable which is protected from the atmospheric conditions. Okay, these are the cable. So what it consists, let us see. So first, it is the conductor. Next, second layer is the insulation. We air insulation, any time the insulation. Next, so I use the pillars, some pillars here, some insulating papers, pillars, and I use the binding for the 3-4 cables for the core wrapping tape, wrapping insulating material. Next, I use the bedding here, some jute materials, and I use the armoring. And finally, I use the servicing, that is the outer sheath. Okay, so these are the cable, dear students. Okay, this is the plan. At the same time, you draw it in elevation also. Okay, so these are the just very easy to draw figures, cables. Same thing. So by just seeing this one, you use your drafter and your compass, pro circle, you draw it all clearly, neatly. Okay, so dear students, so let us conclude what we have learned in this class. So in this class we have seen that we recalled what is the cables and what are the different types of cables generally used in our electrical engineering field. We have drawn 3-core XLPE insulated armored cables, sectional and plan views, and we have seen a cross-sectional view of 3.5-core cable, and sectional view of the 4-core belted cable, the cross-sectional view of the armored 4-core XLPE insulated armored cables in this class. So here one electrical simplified one YouTube channel, he is explained the clearly the practically cables available in our electrical field. So my sincere thanks to that person and another persons who are helped to improve and give the sharing of the knowledge to the students. Okay, you can see that video also. Okay, so you can see it, you can get the clear idea. You can see he is going to explain a different type of the cables. Okay, so I will give the link also, this electrical simplified channel person's link. So go through the details. I'm going to give the some to create the interest on you. I'm going to show the some small portions. Okay, thanks for that person. So this is the one cable, 3-core cable. So you can see the aluminum conductors over which is a insulation, wire insulation, over which there is a copper sheath also here provided. So you can see the maybe this 3-core cable. Okay, so the copper sheath also provided, over which this pillars also, you can see the pillars also here. You can see the pillars and this insulating material, and here is armoring, you can see, and sheath. Okay, is explaining all these things. So bonding purpose, they will use the another type of the bonding tape. Okay, insulating materials. And you can see here is another type of the insulation, binding purpose, 3 cores are binding purpose, the different type of cables. Okay, here the armals, or you can see this is a pillars, you can inside there is a pillars. Okay, you can see that cables also.
इसके बाद मेटालिक स्क्रीन, ये मेटालिक स्क्रीन है, ये पूरे केबल्स के लिए किया हुआ है, इसके बारे में हम विस्तार से आगे जानेंगे। फिर ये इनर शीथ, यहाँ हमने देखा ये यहाँ पे इनर शीथ, ये दोनों इनर शीथ है। इनर शीथ के बाद आता है आर्मरी, ये राउंड आर्मर है और ये फ्लैट आर्मर है।
So armoring is the galvanized steel. Sometimes we can use the aluminium or steel.
GI outer sheets. ये PVC या fire FRLS fire retardant low smoke cables हो सकते हैं.
Yes, a good experience in the cables.
एक चीज इसके parts के विस्तार के बारे में. ये cable का core है.
It's a 3-core cables.
या copper material का हो सकता है. इसका IS code 8130 है. IEC code 60228 होता है।
So this the field
circular shape
numbers
या compacted shape में हो सकता है।
Compacted, you can see.
Normally कोई भी core रहेगा, उसे इस तरह से अलग-अलग single-single wires को circular shape करके एक single core बनाया हुआ है। इसका reason skin effect होता है। Skin effect को overcome करने के लिए इसे अलग अलग स्ट्रैंड्स को जोड़कर एक कोर बनाया जाता है। इसे हम अपने जब अगला वीडियो बनाएंगे स्किन इफेक्ट के बारे में, तब हम उसे विस्तार से जानेंगे। कॉपर मटेरियल जो रहेगा वो उसका वेट एल्यूमिनियम से डेंस होता है, लेकिन करंट कैरिंग जो कैपेसिटी रहेगी वो कॉपर की एल्यूमिनियम से 1.6 टाइम ज़्यादा होती है।
ओके डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ let us conclude these cables. Please, I am going to give the this drawings by seeing and draw the this neatly in drawing sheets. Okay, so thank you for listening my class, and remaining small portion, the screen cables, will discuss in the next class. Thank you for listening my class.